All right, so what is the net change in Q, U, and W for this? Let's do that first. Okay, so basically it's just adding this all up, right? Okay, so 3955 plus 1080 plus 18,000 is, what just happened? 10,800, minus, whoops. Let's try that again. Only this time let's subtract the 18. Okay, there it is. So this is negative 3245. So what that means is that this much heat flowed out of the gas, okay? Which makes it a heat pump, right? Okay, we're actually taking heat from the hot temperature and putting it to the cold temperature, okay? That's kind of fun. Okay. And then let's look at this guy. Well, this adds to zero, right? And of course, the delta U, if you add all your delta U's up and you don't get zero, you did something wrong. Here's why. Because we started here and we ended here. And that point there has a particular temperature. And the net change in internal energy has to be zero because U is 3/2 nRT. If T is the same, U is the same. Therefore, we didn't change our internal energy. Okay, and then what do you think this is going to be, right? This has to equal this at any level, right? Okay, so I'll bet if we add these together, we'll get this, negative 3245 joules, right? So now we've answered the net Q, U, and W, right? What heat flowed in? Well, this is heat that flowed in here, right? So the net heat that flowed in, heat that flowed out is 18,000, right? But the heat that flowed in is 3955 plus 10800. This is the heat, the positive heats, right? That's heat flowing in. That's 14755. Right, so that's the total heat that flowed in. The total heat that flowed out is this guy, right? 18,000 joules. Okay. So this thing is actually a heat pump. Let's just take a look at this, right? Okay. So right here, as we do this, right, heat flows into this for this expansion, right? And then here, heat flows out, right? Okay, that heat that's flowing out, the heat that flowed in from colder temperatures. This is a colder line. These are all higher temperatures, right? This line here is 298.8, right? Everything here is above that, right? So heat is flowing in from the low temperatures, and then here heat flows out to higher temperatures. Heat flows out to higher temperatures, okay? So that's how a heat pump works. That's where the cold side of your fridge is coming from, right? We could talk about that in class a little bit here. Okay, so the heat that flows out in CA heats your house. So this is the heat we get, right? 18,000 joules. And then the work we put in was 3245, right? Remember, this is work we did on the gas. So if you divide those, you get 18,000 divided by 3245. You get 5.547. or 5.55. Now, you know, this is not its efficiency. This is the coefficient of performance, which is some arbitrary thing. And I don't even think that IB wants us to be able to calculate that. But that's what it is. There it is, right? A typical coefficient of performance for a heat pump in Tualatin would be like 3. So this is somewhat idealized. And of course, the reason it's somewhat idealized is that it has an isothermal process. This is a process that takes an infinite amount of time to complete. So, you know, it's not terribly practical. All right.